Hello everyone, I've been working very hard for you guys to share with you all my knowledge about the Unity data-oriented technology stack. The initial plan was to continue the previous tutorial series I've been doing, but I've rewatched some of the episodes and I was not very happy how I built things up. Some of the code from one episode was changed in the next episode, which made things kind of hard to follow. And there's been quite a few changes to the data-oriented technology stack also. So, change of plan, I made an update. For this updated version, the objective remains the same, which is to go from this, an empty Unity project, to being able to do this, which is a full-featured tower defense game. We'll take things slowly, going step by step, each step building on top of the previous one, and for every step you will get access to the full commented code. I honestly feel like this could be a paid course, but I'm making it available for free to you guys. All I'm asking in return is if you can like the video and share it with whoever you think would be interested, because it takes a lot of time and effort to make those videos, to make this content, and I'm not sponsored, I'm not even monetized, so if you can help me share the video, it will maybe help me reach that monetization milestone and support the channel. So if you can like and share the video, it would be really appreciated. Thank you. Okay, now how exactly will we go from an empty project to a full featured game? The first step we'll take is to do a simple health regeneration system. We'll set up the project, look at the editor windows specific to Unity DOTS, learn about the components, the system, the authoring, and the baking workflow, and also talk a bit about the transform usage. Next, we'll make a simple movement system that will allow our enemies to follow a simple path. That will allow us to discover new components such as the high buffer element data. We'll also dive a bit deeper into the transform system with the local transform, and we'll take a peek at the burst compiler and the profiler. Having a single enemy in the tower defense game is not very fun, so next we'll tackle the spawning system. We'll learn about the entity command buffers, the structural change, the prefab stack components, and much more. Now that we have hordes of enemies attacking us, we need to learn how to capture the user input to place tower on the terrain using the physics system. And we'll also introduce the notion of component or entity singleton and allocators. If you can't lose the game, you can't win the game. So next, we'll implement a simple game over system using the physics trigger events and introducing also the job system and the component lookups. A tower that can't shoot is pretty much useless, so let's make our tower able to shoot enemies and kill them. In this step, we'll introduce the concept of blob assets, use the iJob entity, iJob chunk, and aspects. Even if our enemies are simple slimes, they feel a bit lifeless because they are not animated, so let's animate them using the hybrid workflow and introducing the concept of managed component and reactive systems. Next, it would be great to give the player a bit of visual feedback using UI to build some health bar for the enemies and the player itself. We'll introduce the communication between the game object world and the DOTS ECS world. And last but not least, a game with a single level is not very fun, so we'll learn how to manage scenes so that we can build multiple levels, a nice UI, a nice introduction menu, so that it's clean and tidy. And with that, we'll have all the necessary building blocks to make an actual tower defense game. As I said at the beginning of the video, you will have access to the full commented code for every single step of the course. I will make a new step available every Saturday at 5 PM Central European time. I will put other time zone in the video somewhere. And I will use the premiere feature so that maybe we can have some nice interaction during the live show of the episode. That's it. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and share, and see you in the first episode.